Good day, my friends. Welcome back to Your Florida Electrician. Today, what we're going to look at is, have you ever had a situation where you want to have one outlet switched for maybe controlling a light fixture and the other one on all the time? We have that situation here. We have a box up here in the ceiling in the garage. We want to use half of the outlet to run some lights that are going to be installed and plugged in. And the other half, we're going to plug in a garage door opener. So it's two separate circuits. And we want to make sure that we can separate this device into two. It is a duplex, so we can run this one separately and this one separately. So let me show you how that's done. Okay, guys, we're at the light box in the ceiling. It's going to be an outlet box. One thing you want to do when you're doing this type of thing with two circuits in here is keep your head in the game. Okay? We have one wire here that shows receptacle. This one over here is my receptacle. Somehow we want to mark this on the outside because we're going to take the insulation off. We want to mark this on the outside. Where is this one coming in? I'm going to mark it over here with the receptacle symbol. Basically a circle with two lines through it. Okay. This one's not marked at all. And that one's not marked at all. So, tracing that back. Okay, so one goes down there. Yep. So power, these two, this one's power out. So this is going to be two light fixtures. There's going to be one here mounted over here somewhere by a plug. And there's going to be another one down there. It's going to be another light fixture. So basically we have switched power from the switch in and out. And this one is just going to be constant power for the garage door opener that's going to be here for that opening there. So we want this one to be tied on one side of that duplex, these two to be tied on the other side of the duplex. So let's get into how we do this. Let me just double check that that goes down to the switch. Yep, that goes down. And this one on the bottom, doesn't hurt to double check everything. That one goes down there. Okay, good. Yep, so this is my outlet and these are my two switch. I'm gonna put switch and switch. So that way when I get the insulation off, I know what's what. So first thing we do is we gotta get that insulation off of here. I use my diagonals, we call them dikes, to clip back here. Just squeeze a little bit, not too much because you don't want to cut the wire, you just want to score the insulation and it should pull right off. Take the paper off the ground wire. Okay, that's one side of my outlet right there. This one, same thing. I want to get back there, score the insulation. Don't squeeze too tight. You don't want to cut the wires. You don't want to nick the wires. I've been doing this for a while, so I know how to do it. Okay, hopefully my arm's not in the way. This is going to be the other side. And this one. Okay. Take the paper off. Okay. These ones are going to be my light on this side of the outlet. This one is going to be power for my garage door opener. It's okay, if you want to put all the grounds together. In this case, I do want to. Okay, so let's put all the grounds together. So I'm going to push that in the box a little bit, and I'm going to twist these together nice and tight, because I want to put a green wire nut that has a hole on there. Because remember, this outlet, even though we're doing two different circuits on it, all the grounds are going back to the same place. And we can put them all together, even on two different circuits. It's not going to trip anything. Okay, this green wire nut has a hole in it. It allows you to wrap those wires together, cut them, have a little pigtail, if you will, coming off the end, which I can then put a little curl on it for going around the ground. Screw. All right, we want to get rid of this. We want to get this up into the box. Okay, we have a little bit sticking out there for your ground. All right, this is not too bad. This is my side that's going to be for my non-switched outlet. We want this to be on all the time for the garage door opener. In neutral, you want to strip the insulation back about an inch. Okay, both of them. I don't know how much you can see from there. Twist it, because we're going to want to cook. We're going to want to hook these on the termination screws on one side of the outlet. Okay, these you can't get both of these on one half of this outlet. You can't get both on there. Okay, down the bottom is going to be one circuit, on the top is going to be the other circuit. So what do we got to do here? We'll prepare the outlet in a second. So we need to cut these, okay, these two, because we need power for this side for the light, and then we're sending power over there to another outlet for another light. So we're going to cut these here, okay, cut them all nice and even, and then strip them 3/4 of an inch to an inch, okay. Sorry if my arm's in the way, I apologize. Got nobody to hold the camera, which is fine. In this case, you'll need a couple pigtails. I got some extra wire kicking around over here. All right, little short pieces of wire. Those are called pigtails. You're going to want to strip those both the same, 3/4 of an inch to an inch. I usually start with the neutral. You're going to want to put all these together. Not the ones on this side. Just these two that are going to be for the light. Okay, if you can get all those lined up, hopefully you can see that. Get all the ends lined up. Wire nut them together. Okay, so that one's good. Somebody's surely going to point out the box fill in this box. It is a little bit over because we use 12 wire. Needs 2.25 cubic inches per wire here. I believe this is like a 18 cubic inch box, and I think we're at 20.25 or something with the device installed. Let's see. All right. But in case you're going to point that out in the video, I know already, okay? All right, so we get the pigtails. A little bit too long for me. Go ahead and cut the pigtail. Strip those 3/4 of an inch to an inch. Okay, I want to use my needle nose because I can get a tighter loop on here. Oh, I don't like it. I don't think I stripped the insulation enough. Okay. All right, that's nice. The only thing I don't like is I got to get rid of these wires. And the wire nut's going to go inside the box. Okay, don't get these wires mixed up. Okay, there we go. All right. I know, I'm going to have 6 inches sticking out, but I would have it. There we go. Remember, this side, constant power. This side switched. Now tied together onto that one. Okay, now we need to prepare the outlet. I think I need to come down so I can see what this thing sees. Okay, how do we prepare this outlet? We want to use 1/2. Let's see how this is facing over there. Okay, up in the ceiling, they're all the same this way. So, this side I want to use for my switched, and this side I want to be constantly hot for garage door opener, okay? You see these little tabs in between? See that little tab right there that connects these two? Has a little handle on it, sort of. That's it. We want to take these needle nose and break it off. Okay. Grab that with the needle nose. Just wiggle it like that. Look at that. Do you see it? It's gone now. You see that? It's stuck in my needle nose. Bye-bye. And we want to do the exact same thing on this side. That's going to separate the top from the bottom. We don't want these wired together with two different circuits. You turn it on, it's going to go boom.
Removing the neutral tab in this case is critical. Because we are working with two separate circuits, we don't want to overload the neutral if both circuits end up on the same phase. If this was a simple half-hot outlet on the same circuit, you could leave the neutral tab intact.
So, Same thing, we grab a hold of that little tab. Okay, just bend it back and forth a little bit and it should snap right off. Okay, can you see that's not connected anymore? It's right there, there's the metal piece, bye. Get out of there. That's it. Now we have two separate outlets. They're not wired together, they're not gonna cause a problem. Okay, we're back up at the ceiling. Okay, I want this way, this one switched. This one unswitched. I always do the ground first. Remember, the ground doesn't matter. We want that ground connected. We can put the grounds together, which we did. And where's my big screwdriver? Tighten these. There is a torque value. If you're a person that likes torquing stuff, there is a torque value somewhere listed on this outlet. I just put it tight. Okay, now don't mess this up. This is going to go this way in here. Okay. My neutral goes on the other side. Neutral's always the same side as the ground. Okay, and I want this one to be my always hot for my garage door opener. Okay, so this is where you got to keep your head straight. So I want this top one. I want this to be my neutral. Okay, for that side. Okay, so just do one at a time so you keep your head in the game. You screw this up, you're going to turn the one breaker on, it'll be fine. You're going to turn the other breaker on, it's going to go bang. So to make this work properly, because it is two different circuits, I am going to do one side complete so I can't screw it up. All right, you see that wire is going on this side here. I want the same matching wire to go on the opposite side, which is my hot. Oop, I wanted to go clockwise. Yep, I got it, clockwise. Hopefully you can see this. My apologies, I can't see what you see. Little nose. This is kind of a rarity, but instead of having a separate outlet and then another box, simpler to do it that way if you don't know how to do this. But if you do know how to do this, you may have a use for this. Particularly in a garage situation, you can have all your top outlets switched if you have lights along the walls, if you wanted to do that. Or equipment or chargers, not EV chargers, but battery chargers. And then you want the bottom outlets to be hot all the time for using for something else, who knows. But if you wanted to do that, knowing how to do this, you can do it. All right, now the other side. So this one's wired hot now. Is that the one I wanted wire hot? Doesn't matter. Yeah, it is. Okay, so back to the neutral. One circuit's done complete. Now we want to do this one complete. Okay. Tighten it up. There's no connection now between the top and the bottom outlet, so we can have two different circuits on here. And they can be switched or non-switched. They can both be switched if you wanted to by different circuits for whatever reason. Okay, now back to my hot side. Put my little pigtail on there. Needle nose. Pinch these wires around. You want a good connection. If you have a 20 amp outlet, it'll allow you to use the stabs, I believe, in the back with a 12 wire, but I hate stab ends. Don't use the stab ends. Nothing but problems. The wiring tends to get hot, cold, hot, cold, hot, cold from using the electricity in the stab ends. It has a way of working out. So coming back out. I hate them. All right, so we have the wiring for always on for the garage door opener. Boom. This side is switched. Boom. Nothing's touching except for the grounds. The grounds is okay. You get a lot of wire in here and wire nuts. You want to make sure you push the ground, push the wires back into the box as you push this up. The last thing you want is that ground wire touching anything that's energized or even the neutral. It can cause a problem with arc fault breakers. Better cheat a little bit. Use a screw gun. Just so much easier. Guys, if you're getting any value from this, you think you're going to use something like this or whatever, a light went off in your head and you're like, oh man, I can wire my garage like that. You can put all the tops one way and all the bottoms the other way. You can do some really stuff off of one outlet. Don't confuse this with a half hot that's on the same circuit in your bedrooms and stuff. Sometimes you have a switched outlet. They only break the hot side. They don't break the neutral. This one, circuits, we want to break the neutral. Okay? So don't get that confused. Don't mix this with a half hot. It's not a half hot. This is a half switched with two different circuits. And that's that. Now with that, there. Garage door opener, always on. If we had that switched with this one, the garage door opener would only work when the switch is on, right? And this one's switched for future light. And there's another one down there that's gonna be entirely switched for a future light. And on this side, there's gonna be a garage door. So we wanna plug that garage door opener into an outlet that's gonna be on all the time.